YouTube, what is up? We are back. We're finally back on the YouTubes, and I'm ready to give you guys some great content, some awesome workout footage. Not the most interesting one for you today, but I'll take you through my workout. I'm starting a new phase of hypertrophy, right? Hypertrophying the muscle cell in the wall of the muscle, the mitochondria. Good stuff, good stuff. So I just got back from a weekend with Eugene Teo, the muscle mechanic. And I learned quite a lot. This is the third time that I actually went, and I feel like it actually clicked in my head of, wow, that's what you do with the muscle. You activate it and then you can strengthen it. So I'll take you through some of the stuff that I learned today, especially the breathing drills. So we'll start with the breathing drills. But first I wanna show you how I plan my workouts. Well, I don't plan my workouts. I have a coach. Yeah. So my coach, I've been working with him. My coach. Been working with him for about over a year now, and he always uploads like a little thingy, my Bobby. So all my program's in here. But I don't like looking at my phone too much. Here's a quick tip for you: don't look at your phone during your workout. Actually write it down in my little book here, and I write little notes on what I'm doing during the workout. And it's actually, like, you could probably see some of my workouts, like, that was not much, didn't do much there. But when I, oh yeah, so when I do shit like that, and it's just covered, it's like a good workout because it gets you in the zone. So a little pro tip for you: write down, get yourself a book, write down your workout. Same thing you can do with your goals and your journaling and stuff. But that's another story. So let's get into this breathing. All right, what we're gonna do, you have your autonomic nervous system, big fancy word, right? So there's two branches of this autonomic nervous system. You have your sympathetic and your parasympathetic. You don't need to know that. You just need to know stress, sympathetic, so stress is bad, fight or flight, fright, and then you've got your parasympathetic, which is your good, your recovery, so your rest and digest. What's happening, so most of us living stressed out lives, right? If you wake up in the morning, you're stressed. This is our baseline. So our baseline's here, our stress level, most of us is going to be up here. So this is stress, this is rest. We're sitting about here. What this breathing drill is going to do is shoot you up into an acute sympathetic stress, and then it's going to shoot you back down, and then your new baseline is sort of just below here. So the breathing drill, what we're going to do is breathe in through the nose, filling up the sides of our belly, and then forcing all of the air out with our mouth. So breathing out through pursed lips, or this. So you'll be spinning, you'll be going red in the face. You wanna get that feeling of being choked, suffocating, passing out, sort of feeling in your brain, because that's your brain telling your stomach muscles to contract, and that's what we want. We wanna activate and contract all of our stomach muscles. Once you've breathed out all of the air from your lungs, and that's contracting really hard, you're gonna push your tongue to the roof of your mouth, hold your pee in, so ladies, do your Kegel exercises, and it's gonna force all of the air out, keep it out so no air gets in, and you're gonna hold it out for 5 seconds. So, recap, breathe in through the nose, fill up the sides, force all of the air out with your mouth through pursed lips as hard as you can, hold it out for 5 seconds, pushing the tongue to the roof of your mouth and holding your pee in, bracing the sides of your body. Gonna do about 5 to 10 breaths. Let's give it a crack. It helps if you have really bright lights above you as well, so it's like you're in an operating room. I love it. Okay, oh, also we're gonna push our hips up. Forgot to say that. So hips up, in through the nose. Oh my god. Woo! Shit. You can really feel that strong contraction.
You want to find a sweet spot of how many breaths you can do. You can do this too much and you'll be feeling lightheaded and pretty crappy for the rest of the day. Do the right amount of breaths, you'll feel a lot more energized. So I feel ready to go. The warm up for today's workout, we're doing a bit of everything. I still like to do skipping. So most workouts I do skipping, 2 minutes, gets the blood flowing. I'm also gonna add in some hollow body rocks, something else I learned on the weekend. So some hollow body rocks, get the full body work, the compression, hold your pee in, tongue roof the mouth, really gets everything fired up. Fun fact with the breathing. Before I do the breathing drills, I would never be able to get more than like 10 double unders. Just then, double unders all day. Well, only 30. I think I still need to work on my technique, but let's get it out. Breathing.
Alright, this phase is all about the tempo. So you need to come down slow, pause at the bottom, and drive back up. This exercise is a bit weird. I'm not doing it for chest, right? I'm doing it for the front delt, anterior delt. So, not much of an arch. Coming down as slow as I can before the shoulders turn in. Keep tension on the shoulders and drive back up.
Part of the workout. Now we're going to do some legs at the end. To warm up the hip flexors, we've got this cool exercise, lying pike pulse. Really focus on opening up that inner quad muscle, the rec fem. Check it out. That'll really help with your squat depth and open up the hips. Legs are so annoying because I just want to go heavier. I know I can go heavier. Oh, so now I'll back off the weight 10% and do one more set. And then we'll do some curls to finish. That's the workout done there. Back at home now, after that last calf exercise, it was a calf exercise. You just do the first part of the range of motion, loads up a ton on the calves. If you do not believe me, try it, because I have never experienced such a pain before, like in the gym. That was ridiculous. I crawled up in a ball and started crying after that exercise, but I'm still alive. So I'll be doing those every day, trying to do them every day for the next month or 40 days. Do them every day for 40 days. Wow. Oh, okay. I'm definitely going to be working on my tears, crying a lot. Anyway, after that gym session, train someone in my uniform, come home, I've got some food here, big salad, some pork, some sourdough bread, and the main thing is Game of Thrones. So Monday, it's Game of Thrones time. So I'm gonna sit back, relax, watch some Game of Thrones. Now, if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. If you didn't enjoy the video, hit the subscribe button. Any questions, hit me up on my socials, Facebook, Instagram, Mitch Ping. Yeah, catch you later.